and welcome to the Berks History Center's March 2016 program on BCTV. My name is Sime Bertolet. I'm the director of the Berks History Center and your host for this show. Tonight, I'm privileged to be joined by Vicky Heffner, the education curator for the Berks History Center, as well as Valerie Malmberg, noted art authority and co-owner of Greshville Antiques and Fine Arts. Tonight, we're recording this segment for BCTV at Greshville Antiques and Fine Art in Boyertown, Pennsylvania. Welcome to March 2016 program. The Berks History Center is open Tuesday through Friday from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. and on Saturday from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. The Henry Janssen Library is opened Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. and on Saturday from 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. The Berks History Center is located at 940 Center Avenue at the corner of Center Avenue and Spring Street, and that's about a mile south of the First Energy Baseball Stadium. The Henry Janssen Library is located directly behind the Berks History Center at 160 Spring Street.
Help the Berks History Center and the Henry Janssen Library preserve the history of Berks County by becoming a member to the Berks History Center. Memberships start at $35, $55 for an individual, and $65 for a family. Membership benefits include 4 issues of our quarterly magazine, The Historical Review of Berks County, free admission to our museum and library, and free admission to all of our exhibits.
You can join the Berks History Center in a number of different ways. Probably the easiest is to go online to www.berkshistorycenter.org. and apply online, or you can call the Berks History Center at 610-375-4375. Ask for Amy Smith, our membership coordinator. She can sign you up that way. But maybe the best way is to just stop by the Berks History Center when you can join right there at our main location, and then take a tour of all the facilities in addition to receiving your first free copy of the Historical Review of Berks County. Remember, admission is free to the Berks History Center Museum as well as the Henry Janssen Library.
Another added benefit to the membership is 10% off in our museum store, which has recently been renovated again. We have beautiful pottery, baskets, and also lots of books.
And I'll mention one more thing. The membership to the Berks History Center makes a great gift. It really does. In addition to supporting a cornerstone, one of the bedrock organizations of this community that helps preserve the historic legacy that we all share as members of the Berks County community. So I urge you to join that. But while we're talking about membership, I also urge you to support the organization who's bringing you this program, and that's BCTV. You know, only in Berks County, or one of the only places, do you get the quality programming, interactive programming that BCTV provides to the community. Interactive programming that tells you what's going on in the community and really what makes us unique as a community. So I urge all of you to join BCTV. For $45 for a year's membership, you can help BC continue to bring you programming such as the Berks History Center program every month. And you can mail your check to your membership to BCTV at 1900 North 13th Street in Reading, Pennsylvania, 19604. Now, before we get to the main part of our program, why don't we talk a little bit about some upcoming events and some of the things we've got going on here at the Berks History Center. The Berks History Center's March, second Saturday program, is going to take place on March 12th. And the program is part of Women's History Month, and it's entitled Girl-Centric, Painting the Canvas of Art and Feminism in Berks County. And this program is going to be presented by this evening's guest, Valerie Malmberg, and she's going to be talking more about that topic later on in the program, so we'll wait till then to discuss that in more detail. But make a note of the date of Saturday, March 12th. Programs start at 9:30 with refreshments, and the lecture program that Valerie will be presenting is at 10 o'clock.
And I might add that the admission for that second Saturday program is $5 for members and $8 for non-members, and it does include the museum as well. So after the program's over, you can enjoy 3 floors of our exhibits that highlight Berks County's history. On March the 19th, which is also a Saturday, I will be teaching a market weaving basket, and it starts at 9 a.m. A market basket was one of the most basic baskets used in the colonial period and later. It is $45 for members and $55 for non-members. I hope to be done no later than 2 p.m. that day, although I think most people will be done by 12:30 or 1 o'clock. And that includes all materials as well as instruction.
Sounds good. Then let's, while we're in the month of April, on the BCTV, BHC's April 2nd Saturday program is going to be taking place on the 9th, and that is going to be revisiting a topic that is really popular at the Berks History Center, that of the Civil War. That month's program is going to be titled Flames Beyond Gettysburg, the Confederate Expedition to the Susquehanna River in June of 1863. Should be a really exciting program. It's going to be presented by the noted Civil War authority and author, as well as tour guide, Scott L. Mingus, Sr. So we're looking forward to that. And Vicky, you have some bus trips coming up.
I have two day trips coming up and another multi-day trip. On Tuesday, April the 12th, we will be enjoying a trip titled Amish Lands, featuring Samson at the Millennium Theater. We're leaving a little bit later in the day, just after noon, and we'll be going to see a matinee of Samson at the Millennium Theater, which is their new show. And then we will be traveling to an Amish homestead for an Amish dinner, served by Henry and Linda Stosfus. And I might also add that a good friend, Paul Kurtz, is going to join us on that trip. So while we're traveling in the bus, he will be giving us history of Amish living in Lancaster as well as Berks County. So I'm looking forward to that trip very much. I also have a trip scheduled on May 15th to the 17th. It seems to be very popular. I'm getting lots of calls about it. It's a 3-day, 2-night trip to see castles of New York. Okay. We'll be traveling to the St. Lawrence River Valley. We'll be visiting Bolt Castle as well as Singer Castle. We'll be making a stop at Lucas Vineyards. And then also the gardens up there, Sonnenberg Gardens, will be part of that trip.
That does sound like fun.
Charlie Adams will be doing another bus trip for us on Saturday, June the 4th. This time we'll be going to historic Princeton, where we'll be doing a walking and a driving tour of the Princeton area in the morning. We'll also be going to the last headquarters of Washington during the American Revolution, Rockingham, in the afternoon. And then we'll be visiting Grounds for Sculpture, which is just newly opened. The cost for this trip is $90 for members and $100 for non-members. And I don't think I mentioned the price of the Amish Lands trip. That's $145 for members and $155 for non-members. So please do call me if you're interested in any of these trips, and I can give you additional information.
That's a pretty busy spring schedule.
It is.
Wow. Okay, well, before we get to the topic for the this evening's program, part of our strategic plan that the Berks History Center engaged in back in the summer of 2014 that we put together, one of the elements that came about from that is we wanted to design an educational series that was geared to adults, that talked about the history of Berks County and called an introduction to Berks history. And Vicky, working along with Kim Brown, our director of libraries and archives at the Henry Janssen Library, and Lisa Adams, have come up with a really exciting program that's going to be taking place on Saturday, April 23rd, from 8:30 a.m. till 4 p.m. And Vicky's going to tell us a little bit about the programs that we've got coming up at that conference and some of the speakers that are going to be there.
Starting at 9 o'clock, our very own Kim Brown, Director of Library and Archives, will be presenting Into the Woods, European Civilization Meets Colonial America. And we're very, very happy to have Patrick Dunmoyer back. He will be speaking in the morning as well. We had close to 70 people at his second Saturday program in February when he talked about powwowing. His presentation, though, in April will be Pennsylvania Dutch Landscape, A Legacy of Belief, Identity, and the Persistence in the New World. And then after lunch, we will have Candace Kinzer-Perry from Schwenkfelder's Museum, and she will be talking about Beyond Toffshine, an exploration of Berks County Frochter from Bethel to Hereford. So we're very, very excited about this conference that we're hosting. With your payment, you will also be given a lunch, a very nice lunch. And also there will be tours of the new galleries at the Berks History Center that have recently opened. I'd like to tell you that it's $25 for students, $50 for BHC members, non-members are $60, and if you wish, you can join for the conference at a special price of $95. So that would include a new membership and also your conference fee.
That's a good deal.
Yes, really, and if you could please call by April 2nd. That is the reservation deadline for that event.
I want to thank Berks Packing, our good friend Pat Boylan at Berks Packing, for being the sponsors of this program, as well as the Reading Eagle companies. Really appreciate their support for this. And you get a lot of bang for your buck on this. And I think there have been a lot of calls coming in
yes.
for this.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we have. This has been really a successful event. Well, okay, with all that said, let's move on to our guest for tonight, and we're going to be talking to Valerie Malmberg about feminism and the artists of Pennsylvania. Well, we're here today at Greshville Antiques and Fine Arts with the Berks History Center's longtime friend, Valerie Malmberg. And Valerie's going to talk to us today as part of the Women's History Month about some of the female artists in Reading and Berks County. So, Valerie, there is a distinct legacy of women in prominence among the artists here in Berks County.
Absolutely. And thank you, Sime, for having me speak
Absolutely.
For Women's History Month. I want to start out with a few questions for you. Did you know that 51% of visual artists today are women?
No, I didn't, but it doesn't surprise me.
Only 28% of museum solo exhibitions spotlighted women in 8 selected museums throughout the 2000s.
Okay.
Only 27 women are represented in the current edition of Janssen's Survey History of Art, and that's up from 0 in 1980.
Okay.
And from the 16th through the 19th centuries, women were barred from studying the nude model, and that was the basis for academic training. And lastly, though women earn half of the Masters of Fine Arts degrees in the United States, only a quarter of solo exhibitions in New York galleries feature women.
So where's the disconnect? Most of them are self-trained, it would seem to me.
Most are self-trained. These are all interesting facts, and no wonder Georgia O'Keeffe, one of my favorite artists, made this famous statement, "The men like to put me down as the best woman painter. I think I'm one of the best painters."
Yeah, okay, right.
My lecture is going to be based on Girl-Centric, Feminism and Art in Berks County. My interest in Berks County art began unexpectedly with the purchase of a beautiful print of a hen and chicks by Ben Ostrian. I was attracted to the heartwarming depiction of motherhood, as I was a young mother myself at that time. I was so drawn to it that I spent our week's grocery money on it, which was $35. This was years ago. Not knowing that it would lead me on a fantastic journey into the world of Berks County art, it was the beginning for me. That was over 35 years ago. And I've been pursuing interest and research in these beautiful paintings ever since. One of my mentors was Juliet Best, who was a doctor's wife from Leesport, and she was an artist and a painting restoration person at the time. She encouraged me to research and learn all that I could about the artists that she so dearly loved. In 1981, my husband Kurt and I opened Greshville Antiques, that is housed in this beautiful 18th century stone barn. And we primarily offered clocks and furniture at that time. But as our love for these paintings grew, our walls became filled with art, and it's now 75% of our business. Many of the artists of Berks County art that are primarily known today are people like Christopher Shearer, Ben Osterian, Spang, Devlin, and Razor. People don't often think of the female artists that were involved at the early 1900s through about 1920. Took a lot of digging to expose the information for a lot of these women. It wasn't uncommon over centuries of painting, even in Europe, that women's artwork got lost. Many female artists were ignored. They changed their names when they became married. Records changed in the history books. Oftentimes, they would be students of male instructors, and their artwork would be attributed to those instructors. I'd like to touch on a few of the female artists that were working in Berks County. One of my favorite artists is Mary Lace. She's probably the most well-known because of her connection to Christopher Shearer. This particular painting is in my private collection. It is a painting of the studio of Christopher Shearer himself. In a 1924 Reading Eagle newspaper article, Christopher Shearer is quoted as saying, "Mary does good work. She came to me for lessons long ago, and it was quite a while before I found out that she was earning $1.50 a week, but spending $1 an hour for lessons. So I said she had better come and live with Mrs. Shearer and me and work in my studio. There she would have more advantages and a better chance of selling her work." Mary was fortunate to have such a good mentor, teacher, and person interested in promoting her career. This is another beautiful painting by Mary Lace, a watercolor of a mill. She often painted near Tuckerton and Onalani and utilized concepts of soft color to produce emotional works. Her favorite subjects were flowing streams, grist mills, spring houses, and always colorful foliage. Mary enjoyed painting watercolors of beautiful women and children. This particular painting is one of my favorites. She has a young woman with a flamboyant hat. Many people don't realize that as a teenager, Mary worked in a millinery store with her sister, and I'm sure she carried some of those fond memories through in her artwork. Another beautiful painting of hers is of a gypsy girl. Mary had a huge connection to the gypsy camps. We've seen a number of paintings of not only the camps, but of the children involved in their society. And I love the deep set eyes, the dark curly hair, and of course the colorful scarves and ribbons. So as you can see, Mary was very influenced by Christopher Shearer, who was the reason that her work was promoted so strongly within the county. I'd like to show you a few other paintings. Here we have a spider mum, still life, by Mary Laura Schenfelder. It's an antique painting, but it has almost a contemporary quality to it. She was married into the Schenfelder family in Reading that was the bricklayer family, brickmaking company, who also made stoneware in Berks County. The interesting fact about Mary's paintings are she was self-taught through the local schools. She did take an opportunity to study in Philadelphia, and when she returned to Reading, she opened up a studio and offered art classes to support herself. Unfortunately, Mary's work has taken a loss with attribution. She became known as Mrs. Harry Schenfelder. So a lot of people do not recognize her work as Mary Laura. It's unfortunate because a lot of her paintings now are attributed to other artists, and people don't realize that that was her work because of her labeling as Mrs. Harry.
Is that how she signed her paintings, Valerie?
She signed, some paintings are signed Schoenfelder.
Okay.
Some paintings are signed M.S. And a lot of people do not recognize her work. So what I've been doing is studying, identifying, mm-hmm. and attributing a lot of the paintings okay. to her.
Interesting.
It is, and it comes about because of records being titled as Mrs. Harry Schoenfelder. But was very common in those days.
Sure.
The last painting I'd like to speak about is by Annie Snyder. She was from Salona, Pennsylvania, born in the mid-1800s. This is a beautiful oil on canvas landscape of a lady walking across a bridge with her cattle. Oftentimes, artists were self-taught, as was the case with Annie Snyder. She had only a brief stint of instruction in Philadelphia. She is the epitome of what the female artist struggled with during their careers. She actually came back to Salona, where she was born, then came to Reading for a while, where she opened a studio, was not able to sell many of her works. She was not accepted by the male colony of artists here, and she actually went door to door raffling tickets for her paintings. Interestingly enough, there are no exhibition records of her works during her lifetime. And in the 1970s, there were three retrospective exhibitions held in Salona, in her hometown. And the majority of her works now are held in the Heise Museum. She died in the 1920s with not much of recognition of her work at that time, and it's come about since her death. One of the most fascinating female artists of Berks County was Matilda Neville Spang. She was born in 1871 and was the daughter of Frederick Spang, the well-known artist who had two brothers who were also artists. Tilly, as she was known, studied portraiture at the Pennsylvania Academy of the Fine Arts in Philadelphia, and her studies were interrupted a year later upon the death of her father when she was needed to return to Reading. She decided to do something crazy for a woman in the 1890s. She decided to study in Paris. She was accepted in 1895 to the Salon. Spang studied under the renowned artist William Bourgeois. This was a fantastic opportunity for her. Bourgeois was credited with single-handedly allowing women into the French academies. He was renowned for capturing the soul of his sitters with unequaled perfection, and he's considered one of the greatest artists of all time. Michael Jackson collected his artwork.
Good.
And spent millions of dollars per paintings. Spang returned to America after studying in Paris, and she opened a studio in Philadelphia and exhibited at the Pennsylvania Academy of Fine Arts. With her knowledge and experience of the Parisian art organizations, she returned to Reading and decided to open and establish a fabulous art organization. Unfortunately, it was not accepted by the male-dominated colony of artists in the town. This particular painting was a draped woman, and it was done, and it is titled on the back with the title of the painting, the salon, and the address. It's an oil on panel in its original frame, and it is a piece that she brought back to America after studying in Paris.
Well, this is especially interesting because recently, the Berks History Center was called, I took the call, by a lovely woman by the name of Mary Alice Mumma, who lived in Mechanicsburg. She had her roots in Reading, but she had asked us if we would be open to a donation of a portrait. And I said, absolutely, we definitely entertain that notion. And so Kim Longlot and I went down to have a look at this. Well, the Historical Society isn't different from many other ones, but when you look at the portraiture of our and the subjects, it's a bunch of dead old white guys. Okay, much like the conversation we had, a very few women, but just dead old white guys, which is great because they were historic figures in Reading and Berks County. But this particular portrait was different. Okay, we call her Cousin Catherine. That's because what the benefactor who gave it to us was. And Catherine Regal Luce is her actual name. But it's a lovely portrait in that.
I've seen it.
And you have seen it. And it's a lovely young woman in a beautiful gown, in rather an unusual shape. It's very slender and tall. So it's unlike anything we have. And we're very proud to have it because we have it on display in the lobby of the History Center. We think so much of it. But
And it's very Bourgeois. It has
explain
all
that.
Very Bourgeois. Yeah. As Tilly studied with Bourgeois, she picked up some of his techniques with painting faces, highlights on the cheeks, the deep-set eyes. And as I looked at that portrait, I was stunned when I walked in to the Historical Society and saw this beautiful portrait because I was unaware that you had acquired it. And immediately I felt attached to it. And it is the style of Bourgeois. Through the hand of Tilly Spang.
It's beautiful. I mean, as Valerie described it, it's exactly the way it is, the facial expression on it. It's lovely. We really, really do like it. And Ms. Luce was a very, she was a unique figure in Berks County in that she wrote under a nom de plume, I think George Schock, wrote histories of the Pennsylvania Dutch. And we never knew who it was. And I'll never forget when I went over to our director of libraries and archives, Kim Brown, and I said, do you know, and she said, oh, yes, we use it all the time. I will said, she pointed to the painting. I said, well, that's him. And so it's really
and lovely he is.
And lovely he is. And but even better, as part of the donation, I mean, Ms. Luce was, she was an adventuress, let's say. She used to travel extensively in Latin America, and along with the portrait, we got a nickel-plated derringer
She
used to carry in her hip pocket while she was riding through the rough country with her guide down in Central America. So it's really, it's a pretty neat story, and we're really proud to have
it. You never know where paintings will take you.
Oh, it's wonderful. I appreciate you talking to us about Tilly Spang, because she's near and dear to our hearts. Anyway, Valerie, I want to thank you so much
for
being on the program tonight. This has been very informative and really is going to set the tone for our Women's History Month Second Saturday program, which we thank you also for being for hosting for us. And we thank the Berks County Commission for Women for sponsoring and contributing to make that event happen. So I want to thank you for joining us. It's been a great program.
Thank you, Sime.
You bet. Well, I want to thank you for joining us tonight, but I also want to thank Vicky Heffner and Valerie Malmberg for being part of this tonight's show. Tells you a lot about Berks County, our history, and the many facets that are incorporated within it. I encourage you to visit the Berks History Center and the Henry Janssen Library to see our beautiful new exhibits that we have on our second floor education gallery, as well as down in the trades to industry room, as well as the many other transportation rooms, and the Pennsylvania German Room and the Model Room. You can also watch past programs of this show if you go into the BCTV archives. So, thank you very much for joining us, and we look forward to seeing you in April 2016 for our BCTV BHC program. Thank you.